Ladies and gentlemen, we are the RK Tokens. I go by the name of Cleo Thomas, a.k.a. Mr. Slick Living.
I'm Patrick Clout.
And I am the Anomaly Will Ferrell.
I am bringing you guys a trailer for a brand new Netflix film called His House. Now, we all saw what happened when Jordan Peele decided to make horror films that made sure to star black actors. It was something that, you know, we really hadn't seen before. He's opened up a door for more creatives out there, more storytellers to be able to share their stories and hire other black actors. This one, though, in particular, is very interesting because the synopsis says, as a young refugee couple tries to start over in England, they're tormented by a sinister force tied to the horrors they escaped in war-torn South Sudan.
Oh.
I find that very interesting. They are coming from South Sudan. They moved to London, England, and if there's anything that has taught us, you know, we all have African, you know, heritage, so we know what it's like for certain spirits and how our grandmothers talk to us about, you better be careful, the voodoo coming. That's a whole thing to deal with. And now they're getting a chance to tell it in this story, so I'm really excited for you guys to see this trailer. I've already checked it out, but I cannot wait to see Will and Pat's reaction to this.
And this is a horror film?
It is a horror film, yes, sir. Let's check it out.
Yeah.
Love it.
Congratulations. You're being released as asylum seekers, not as citizens, not yet. You will be sent to a home of our choosing. You must not move from this address.
We are good people.
Whether or not you're good people, it's not me that needs convincing.
It's a palace.
This entire house is just for us.
It's gonna be nice, you're gonna be happy.
As long as you can get along, fit in,
be one of the good ones.
This is our home.
All I can taste is the metal.
We'll get used to it.
I saw something in the dark. You have felt it too.
You having problems with the property?
This is what they want. They like to see us crazy. Let them send us back.
How quickly you forget. Everything we went through to get here. We are not going back. There is no witch.
What is that?
Rats.
Rats did this.
You went outside.
This is my house! This is my house! This is my house!
You don't wonder what it tells me. It says I should be afraid of you.
Wow.
I'm in.
I love it.
Yes.
Here's what I love, man. Jordan Peele, like, people need to realize, like, what he's done with first of all, the fact that he went from sketch comedy to Get Out is the wildest thing in history. But what I love about what Jordan Peele does is what he did was, like, he changed the horror game. Like, this whole genre that Get Out was, it like started a new, I think it's called, I forget what it's called. It's called like social horror or woke horror. I forget what it's called, but it's literally a new genre that, like, it's horror, but it still touches on, like, real issues, which elevates it into just, like, instead of a slasher movie where it was a bunch of kids who went to camp and had sex who got killed, it elevates it into, like, a meaningful piece of art. And then not only that, like, he changed, like, you hear, like, the musical score is kind of similar with the little bloop, 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 like just like how creepy the sound is from, like, Us and Get Out. And then, like, first of all, when you have black people in the leading spot in horror. It accesses like a whole new culture that you never mm-hmm. see in horror films, because it's always white people. It's always camp. And you know what I mean? Like my parents are gone, and you know, like I have some people over, and you access like a whole nother storyline that it's not the same scary movie over and over again. And then the third thing is just aesthetically, like the dark skin in the dark. It's just like you have to get specific directors of cinematography and DPs to do that, that are specialized in lighting dark skin. And just like what that adds to the horror, like all of Jordan Peele's like close-up shots and like that famous shot of the dude in Get Out with the like with the wide eyes going into the sunken place. It's just like it's so beautiful. It's such a dope aesthetic in horror. So I'm all the way in.
But I was gonna say this: the idea that, I mean, if I'm thinking about every single horror. Like I fell off a horror around when I saw, I don't know, the 18th exorcism of somebody at some time in some place. That's yeah. when I was like 15, 16 years old. I fell off because, to be honest, we're talking about social horror in a sense.
Yep.
The thing is, when we're doing the whole social horror thing, that is coming from someone who obviously us as black people, we obviously are actually scared of certain things, yep. socially. White people are not scared of anything, so they literally do not have the backbone or the background to do this. Like they can't do it at all, because socially speaking, if you look at it like that, they can't do it. It just can't.
I mean, how many times are we supposed to see a brand new married couple with a new baby move into a house?
Amityville Horror. How many times have we seen Amityville Horror? How many times have we seen it?
It's like the social trauma of what we're getting ready to witness. Even with this film in particular, it's like they came from war-torn South Sudan, and knowing whatever was going on in their village, like whatever their beliefs were, like that last line that we hear is like, you know what she tells me? That should be afraid of you. And it's like, yo, we know how African households are. We know how the husband and wife seem to operate in African-led households. Like we've talked to young women and asked the young men as well how their parents were to them. So to know that that's gonna play a dynamic here, because there's a line in there where he says, you went outside. And it's like, yo, even that is a thing that men from that culture have a thing about, like what their wives can and cannot do.
Right.
Like that's a crazy little aspect to add to this film that I'm right. so excited for. And I do agree with you about the lighting, man. As long as they don't have the guy who lit Baby Boy, I think anything else from that, we should be great.
Gotta take the shot. Yeah.
That's a great point what you said about the African household, because it's like we've seen just the same household every single time in horror. So something that in that culture, like, you know, what dictating when they can and can't go outside is something that's brand new and interesting within this genre, when it might just be, like you said, a cultural norm.
Yeah.
It's just like letting more people in. And it's no wonder why The Ring and The Grudge were like the last really two good horror movies until that run of The Conjuring and Insidious and stuff like that, because they anchored it in Asian culture. Like once you start incorporating like this other stuff, you have all these new opportunities to make a dope movie.
Right. Oh yeah. Yeah. And then shout out to the star of it. What I think her name is, Wenmi Masaku, cause she's been and a whole bunch of stuff. So now to be able to see her start like really getting like her shine and being able to star in one. Yeah, because she's been in like Batman versus Superman, Fantastic Beast, Lovecraft Country. She's in there too. So it's like, yeah. So it's just like, this is like, it's cool to see like them kind of even, one, like you said, step out of the norm of the typical family setup like this. But then not only that, showing from a different appeal of a black woman, because you know this is more, she's more on the she's more than the conventional as we normally see, and she's still being strong, holding, like how you just said, like I was told to fear you. You can sense that strong presence in her. But then also too, shout out to Netflix, because the overseas game has been killing it when it comes to movies and series right now. Like this one,
is it Top Boy?
Warrior Nun. What was the other one? Old Guard. Like all of these things are shot overseas.
It's all England or UK?
Yeah, like all over, like UK, Africa, all kind of stuff. So it's like to see like their different take and style on how like action movies go, horror movies go. Like a lot of people don't know the last like Judge Dredd movie, that thing was made in Africa. A lot of people don't know that. Like it was made by like an African, and it was like, I thought it was dope. But you know,
I've never seen Judge Dredd.
Yeah, the new one was dope. It has the dude from The Boys, the star of The Boys. He's Judge Dredd.
Oh, okay.
But he's been. I would love for us to actually know his name moving forward.
Carl Urban.
What is it?
Carl Urban.
The Wolverine looking dude?
Yes. Carl he's Urban. Been Spock in Star Trek.
He's been so many. He's been everywhere.
He is such a great actor, man. Shout out to Carl Urban. He was even in Dune with The Rock. I know that's not a good highlight, but you know.
So this movie comes out on October 30th. I find that great marketing. I find it right on time. There's not a better way to play that. Drop it, boom, on October 30th.
Oh, I mean, I feel like our Halloween parties even a thing this year. I feel like tucking away and watching a scary movie would be the Halloween moves for sure.
Watch parties. I think watch parties are going to be a big thing for Halloween. So I think this is going to be definitely awesome.
Mike went up.
To have us check out when it, on Halloween and drop. So yeah, this is smart enough. God, I like this aesthetic so much.
So good. Who shot this? Do we know?
It just says horror thriller from writer director Remy Weeks.
But is this from Blumhouse Productions?
It does not give me Blumhouse as far as the write-up. Let me double check on that for you. Oh wow, shout out to my dude and black writer and director as well.
Mm-hmm. This is just overseas projects that they give to Netflix and Netflix take them. That's like funny. They're so like, it's such a dope rise overseas right now, like when it comes to like these movies.
Fire.
I love this aesthetic.
Like, I don't know what it is. Like, I don't know particularly what it's called. I don't know how to pinpoint it, but it's like, I can always tell it when it's shot in the UK, because it kind of has like that overcast feel a little bit.
Every time, hazy.
But I love it though, because it's like, it catches that aesthetic of what they're trying to portray.
It's very Netflixy though.
Yeah.
It seems very Netflixy. But yeah, this is dope. That's my favorite thing about late September, is when they start rolling out the scary movie trailers, and it's just like, I'm glad that I was impressed by this.
Yeah, I am excited.
Not to take away from everything going on with this, but also scary movie wise, there's one franchise that maybe stayed alive a little too long for its own doing, but it is coming back again. Scream. There will be another Scream movie.
This year?
David Arquette is returning. Courtney Cox is returning. And then finally, the only person I really cared about to see if she would return to her lead role character, Neve Campbell, will be back as Sidney Prescott.
You can't make a Scream without Neve Campbell.
Say again?
You can't make a Scream without Neve Campbell. Like, I don't give a damn.
They could have done it. They could have just pivoted and not done it.
No.
My question is, though, like, from what I've realized recently with a lot of the films that were scary to us or scary to our parents back in the day, when they brought them back, they didn't hit as well, right? But then I saw one of the newest Halloween movies, the Michael Myers joint. The Rob Zombie ones were pretty good. But that most recent Halloween film was really well shot. Yep. The plot was dope. Like, I was highly invested in it. So I can only imagine what they plan on doing with this upcoming Scream film. Are you guys interested in seeing another Scream at all?
No.
Here, two things. Back on the His House thing, I did not realize that was Doctor Who as the guy that was selling them the house.
Sure is.
So that's even, that makes this even more bigger. And two, it's based off of how they approach this. Are you going to go where it's a satire again and it's supposed to be kind of funny, or is this going to be the serious one where, like, y'all fearing Ghostface? Because, like, Scream 5 was funny.
Ghostface is the worst of the slashers.
I will say this, Pat. The reason why Scream, I feel like, hit is because, obviously, blurring the lines of reality to... It was the closest thing we got to someone actually doing this. Someone could have actually been a serial... The whole serial killer thing. You know, like, of course, Friday the 13th, Jason Voorhees, you're not going to run into Jason Voorhees. That's almost impossible. You can have a dream of what?
You don't want to see Jason of next to all of them. Put them all in a lineup. Ghostface is silly.
That's the one you think you can take. It's like, I'll knock you the fuck out. Right, back up.
He's been parodied so much, like Freddy Krueger. Freddy Krueger isn't scary anymore, but at the element, at the core of it, I'd still be terrified of Freddy.
Right, in your dreams, you would.
But like, you can have a dream of him at any time. You can legit have a dream of Freddy Krueger tonight. You can just have it. That's what scared me about him.
Ghostface doesn't really do it for me.
Yeah, but if you saw Freddy in public, you'll sock Freddy the fuck out. Like,
I'm just gonna say this: the idea that. What they did with Scream, at least to me, when I got older and watched it back, the idea of how they manipulated, like I said, real life, what we're doing now, the idea of having fake phones and setting people up and everything else, like, let's just say they try to modernize it using social media and everything else like that. We'll see how it is. I'm going to give it a shot, is all I'm saying.
That's what's interesting to me. And then to see who's the cameos going to be in this one. Like, who's the new class you're going to put in? Because that was one of the things you always saw. Like, the last one, they had, like, all of those, like, the girls from Modern Family, the chick from True Blood, and all of them. So it's just like, and then, like, where is the lore, like, the slasher stuff? Like, the movie that was within the movie. So we'll see exactly what's going to be going on. So, but... It is Halloween. We're here. The arcade tokens are busting in with the Halloween theme. So we want to thank y'all for tuning in to Token Reacts. Make sure you check out his house dropping October 30th on Netflix. And let us know how you enjoyed. We might even come back. We might even have a watch party. You never know. But make sure y'all subscribe. Get your notifications turned on. Everything so you know when we're coming. And we are the arcade tokens. Shout out to Kadeem the Tech God. I am the Anomaly Will Ferrell.
Leo Thomas, a.k.a. Mr. Slick Living.
I'm Patrick Clout.
And we will catch you next time.
Happy spooky season.